Hi everybody, wanted to do a quick video on my 1972 Vega GT that I'm selling on Bring a Trailer, and thought we'd should do a startup video and then maybe a little bit of walk around so you can see how it runs, hear how it sounds, and hear a little bit about the car. Let's start with doing a startup video. So now I did drive the car here, so it's warm already, but we'll just turn it right on. You can hear the fuel pumps run. You can hear she starts right up. Engine is a 327 out of a passenger car. I think it was out of an Impala. The engine was not built by me, but you can tell she's got a little bit of a lope, a little bit of a cam. She's quite the fast car, I can assure you. You can see the interior is really in excellent shape. Also, aftermarket gauges have been added, so a water temp, volts, and oil pressure. You can see we're running right at 190 degrees, about 45 pounds of oil pressure, and 13.8 volts, just like she should. I'll just walk around really quick so you can hear the exhaust. She's got, like I said, a bit of a lope, as you can imagine. It was kind of a trick getting this dual exhaust system underneath this little tiny car that wasn't built for one. But she runs great, got a ton of power, drives awesome. Let's just shut her down here. Yeah, so that's a startup. You can see, like I said, she runs great. Otherwise, just to talk a little bit about the car. So I purchased the car in 2012 from an owner who was intending to do a V8 conversion. Fortunately, was unable to complete it due to illness, but did do all of the body work on the car and did the suspension part of the conversion, but wasn't able to do the engine part, which is where I took over, as well as finishing up the cosmetics. The body is in excellent shape. Paint and body work are great. I'll just do a quick door closing here so you can see. Door closes awesome with a solid clunk. The V8, as I said, is a 327 out of a passenger car. I think it's from a 63 Impala, but I did not build the motor. A friend of mine had it in a shop and gave it to me, which is kind of him. Turbo 350 automatic transmission. Fortunately, I wasn't able to figure out how to do a manual without hacking up the firewall and hacking up the floor that I didn't want to do. But frankly, with manual brakes and manual steering, I'm kind of glad she's an automatic. One thing I did want to do with this car is make it seem as OEM as possible. Like, this is something that you would lift the hood in 1972 and Chevy would have done stock. So I spent a lot of time on trying to make all the wiring really clean, use as many GM parts as possible. The original overflow bottle, the original washer bottle, pulleys and alternator are from a Corvette. It does have headers that were designed specifically for the Vega. The brake system is all out of the S10 Blazer, so we have manual brakes, rotors, calipers out of an S10 Blazer, which stops great. Also means that your parts availability at your local auto parts store is excellent. Original bumpers were re-chromed. Electric fan in the front. I think I did post online that there's a crack in the grill right there. Haven't been able to source an original grill. American Racing wheels give it a really period correct look. It has all the correct external badging for the Vega GT. We'll do another door close here so you can see. Nice solid clunk, no door shut problems. Vent windows work great. She's a great little car. Spent many years restoring it, and I think the next owner is going to have a ton of fun. Thanks.